Subscribe to Film Companion for your film fix. Hit the bell icon so you never miss an update.
Subscribe to Film Companion.
If you need a companion for your film journey, filmcompanion.in.
Subscribe and they will send you a companion that will go to movies with you.
So welcome back to Film Companion. Lovely to have all of you back. I remember for the first season of Comicstaan, you were not there, Zakir. I talked to both of you some of the other hosts. And I remember somebody saying, mujhe yaad nahi who it was exactly, saying ki they felt inadequate at times kyunki the contestants were so good.
Yeah.
Did you guys have that feeling with season two ever?
We felt that last time, like the caliber of the contestants have gone up so much this time.
Yeah. Really? Better now?
Yeah. Unfortunately. I think because they now know what the show is, they came in to win, which wasn't there in the first season. First season was, as we just discussed, was to survive the show.
Yeah.
Here it was like, no, we know what the show is, and we're going to win it. So there was no time wasted.
They were a lot more competitive. Like it felt like a little bit more of a competition this time around.
Yeah.
We were like, everyone's just bringing their A game.
Yeah.
They
had like prepared their like, so you know, I will do this joke about in this round.
Because
you know, like, you know, there's going to be an anecdotal, observational, topical, so you can start preparing now if you want to apply next year, which is what a lot of the contestants did.
Correct. So, Zakir, you're also a contest winner. Right, 2012 mein shuruaat to Comedy Central se hi hui.
Ji.
Oh.
Yeah, it was a good day.
So, what is the trick, Zakir? What is the key thing in a contest?
Contest ki trick nahi, comedy ki trick hai wo. Aur wo trick hai, comedy mein, main aapko response wise agar batau na, to sabse kam politics hai. In terms of, like, jaise aapko koi bewakoof nahi bana sakta. Ki aapka kaam kharab hai aur log aapko keh rahe hain nahi sahi hai.
Right. जैसे बॉलीवुड में अक्सर होता है,
अक्सर पेट्रनाइज नहीं कर सकता आपको, अरे नहीं समझ नहीं आया लोगों को. यहाँ पे ये सब नहीं होता, हाफ सेकंड का भी गैप नहीं और वहीं में रिस्पॉन्स है. वो आई डोंट थिंक सो कि वो कॉमेडी का ट्रिक है वो, कि अगर आप लोगों को हंसा सकते हैं तो आप जीत सकते हैं. वो बाकी सब बातें बाद में आती है कि उसका क्वालिटी कैसा था, वो कितना अच्छा था, वो कितना नहीं था, आपने किस बारे में बात करी, वो सब एड ऑन है, वो सब आर्टिस्ट का डिस्क्रिशन है. पर एज कमेडियन द बेसिक सबसे बेसिक जॉब आपका ये है कि आप जो कह रहे हैं लोग उस पर हंसे, वो बहुत स्ट्रेस्ड हैं, दुनिया में बहुत टेंशन है, किसी भी बात पर अगर वो हंस सकते हैं तो वो आपका काम वहाँ पे खत्म हो जाता है. उसके बाद आप जो कुछ भी कर रहे हैं आप एहसान ही है दुनिया पे.
Make people laugh.
I think one thing when we used to mentor the contestants, they used to say things like, do you think the judges will say that my premise is not original enough?
Mm-hmm.
And it has to be like, if you're funny, everyone's going to forget everything.
Yeah.
When you're not funny, you know, magically we have comments for you.
Yeah.
You
know?
You magically start finding fault in it. But if you're funny, we all are quiet.
Pretty much quiet. This is just like, well done.
Well done, great job.
Yeah, ठीक है, सही था, क्या कर सकते हैं? अच्छा, चला है, वहाँ पे, वहीं, हम थोड़ी उसको वो कर सकते हैं, नहीं चला.
Zakir,
I don't know if you remember, I'd done a comedians round table 2 years ago. You were on it. And you know, I asked how do you find your voice as a comedian? And everybody said ki you found your voice kyunki log aapki nakal kar rahe hain. Because people were now doing your style.
So
if people are doing your style, how do you stay ahead of the game?
मतलब मेरा ऐसा मानना है कि अगर कोई और, जैसे जोक को लेके भी मेरा मानना है कि वो कहते हैं ना कि क्या mimicry is the best form of flattery. ठीक है, तो मैंने कभी नहीं जाके उनको कहा कि आप मुझे कॉपी करिए. ठीक है, और मैं वो लड़ाई लड़ ही नहीं रहा, मैं वो खेल ही नहीं रहा उन लोगों के साथ में. और दूसरा है कि मेरा खुद का ग्रोथ ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट है मेरे लिए, as compared to who's catching up and who's second, और कोई मेरे जैसा तो नहीं कर रहा है. मतलब अगर उसमें लगा रहूंगा तो फिर मैं काम कब करूंगा? तो as policy, as an artist, I am just trying to tell better stories. I'm trying to have better command over audiences. बेहतर रिश्ता कायम करने की कोशिश कर रहा हूँ. तो मेरा सारा एनर्जी मैं उसमें लगा रहा हूँ. मैं क्योंकि ये एंडलेस है, क्योंकि आज कोई कुछ और कर रहा है, कोई कोई कुछ और करेगा, कोई कुछ और करेगा, तो वो तो कभी खत्म ही नहीं होगा.
सो इन द कॉमेडी वर्ल्ड ये नहीं है, इज देयर नॉट दिस सॉर्ट ऑफ looking sideways to see ki wo kya kar raha hai, or a sense of insecurity, or I mean essentially you could be mentoring your own competition, right?
I definitely, of course, I feel jealous, and it's like it sometimes it does feel like a rat race where people are getting so many like gigs and shows, and you're just like, what, you know?
Correct. Mera kya hoga?
Yeah. What's that? I definitely feel that way, but I also then try to genuinely, I try to like just distance myself from that. I'm actually working on that in therapy. I am, where I'm like, I don't want to attach my success with this being part of the rat race. Like, it's not making me happy. We actually redefined success for myself this morning, where I was like, for me, success means that I'm learning something new, that I'm trying new things, that I'm having fun doing during the process.
Yeah.
So it's not about having many projects. Like for me, like now I want to do like maybe one project every 5 months and really enjoy the process and just have fun with my friends. Like that's why I got into the comedy, and just to remind myself, this rat race is, it made me like not happy.
Yeah, because there's brands, there's shows, there's YouTube views, you know, that's how you guys compete, right?
I think redefining what success meant to me is helping me. Kind of get out of that mind frame.
हाँ वो बदल देने से भी काफी चीजें sort होती हैं जैसे कि what I'm going for is like I've stopped anybody who says that I'm the best or the most popular or just so I try and avoid detach myself from all those tags. The tag which I really want now to have is the most loved comedian of the country. So अगर वो क्योंकि मुझे numbers में invest नहीं करना, मुझे एहसासों में invest करना है, मुझे भावनाओं में invest करना, मुझे feelings के बारे में बात करनी है. और मेरे गुरु, वन ऑफ माय मेंटर्स आयुष तिवारी, ही इज वेरी गुड राइटर, ही हेल्प मी राइट माय शो एज वेल. ही वंस इन 2009 टोल्ड मी दैट एज समबडी हु कम्स टू हिम एज एन फॉर एडवाइजेस, उन्होंने मुझे कहा था कि यार मुझे जितना आता मैं सब सिखा देता हूँ, उससे ना मुझे नया सीखना ही पड़ता है. सो इवन एज अ मेंटर लाइक आई ऑल्सो फॉलो दैट पॉलिसी कि अगर जो आता है वो सब ले लो भाई साहब, और अगर किसी को समझ में आ रहा है तो फिर वो उसी का था, वो हमारा था भी नहीं. And so that I can evolve better, I can learn better.
Yeah. Is it pressurizing, Ken?
The pressure of competition?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I was helping a contestant with a sketch which involved a knife, and he backstabbed me literally. So I was just like, wow, calm down.
What does that mean, he backstabbed you literally?
Literally, yeah. I mean, I think it's true though. I think any comedian I meet will be the biggest comedian tomorrow. So I think my reaction to it is immediately that everybody is great. You know?
Yeah.
So, like, everybody is great. I just happen to have the light on me for a while.
Yeah.
And so while the light is on me, just do what you can. And that is pressure. And I think it's, if you're an artist and you say you don't feel pressure, you're insane.
Right.
Of course there's pressure. If you can't function in it, someone else who's better at functioning in pressure will replace you. So the answer is that it sometimes I can't sleep at night. Because I don't think I've figured it out. Yeah, it's terrifying. And it's scary, and there's no job security. And it sucks.
Yeah.
You're like, the tomorrow's goals, and then what?
Yeah, it's
then
terrifying. What? Yeah. It sucks, yeah. There's no solution. I will be replaced. Yeah. And just have to deal with it.
It is what it is.
It is what it is.
Yeah. Zakir, in that round table, you had said, and I quote, hum country ke sabse progressive or well read.
I take my statement back. Thank you very much. I take my statement. Thank you very much.
Yeah. Statement.
Yeah, I'm.
What is the statement?
No, I realized, yaar, ki bahut saare, nahin, ki we are the most progressive community.
You had said ki jokes chahe hum alag alag karte ho, lekin basic line humko pata hai ki sahi kya hai, galat kya hai, aur सब लोग बहुत अवेयर हैं एज कम्पेयर टू एनी अदर फील्ड.
वो तो कलेक्टिवली है, पर आई टेक माय स्टेटमेंट बैक.
दैट हैज एन एज
डिवाइड. लाइक आई वाज गोना से आई
ग्रोन बेटर एंड आई हैव रियलाइज्ड दैट देयर इज लॉट टू नो एंड आई एम नॉट द बेस्ट पर्सन टू से दैट आई नो एवरीथिंग.
But you didn't say you know everything. I think you were speaking collectively.
All of us. Everybody, we are learning. Like, yeah. Things have changed. A lot of stuff has happened in our industry. And you're like, whoa, so, you know.
So, Kaneez, that was my question. Yeah. That post Me Too, what clearly we saw that it's not the most progressive community. And there is no such great progressive community. We live in a country where this is happening everywhere. Right. So, what has changed in the comedy world since that? You know, since the unfolding of the events of last September, October.
You know, for me, and I'll tell you from my perspective, because it's, I don't, and this might be just me personally, I'm not speaking on behalf of anybody else.
Yeah.
I don't feel scared now for us to ask for what I think I deserve. I genuinely don't. Like, I don't, like, I used to be scared I was going to be labeled a diva or someone hard to work with, or I'm not scared of that anymore. I ask for what I think I deserve. And I think that's a big step, like, not just payment, like, not even just equal pay. Like, first of all, Comicstaan, we all got paid the same, by the way. That's one big thing that happened.
That's huge.
Yeah, we all got paid the exact same amount.
Because I remember, I think Malika Dua tweeted, now there was some show both of you did right. and she was yeah. paid less than you were. I remember that conversation. So but now
we got the same amount. Like I said, for me, it's changed where I feel a lot more, I can ask for what I want. And without feeling bad, without saying sorry. Yeah. I'll be like, sorry, can I have this? I'm like, I think I deserve this and I would like this, please. Mm. I'll say please. But I won't say sorry.
But that's wonderful.
It is really nice. For me, I've just, I feel a lot more, I don't want to say the word powerful, but empowered after that, that I do belong here and I do deserve what I'm asking for and I'm going to ask for it.
And I remember a sort of conversation about sort of the bro code of comedy. You know, the boys are also very supportive of each other. It's not a great place for women, especially the green room is a tough place for women. Has that changed? Has that environment changed at all? It's been 2 years now since we had that conversation.
I mean, I hope it has.
Yeah.
I mean, I think the biggest thing that came out of it was everyone started talking about it, which is, I think, a great
first
step.
The acknowledgement of...
Yeah. And little sensitization of how it should be and where we all collectively are going wrong. But I don't think so we are the right representative of talking about any kind of green rooms.
Yeah.
Because we our lives are such that we hardly share green rooms anymore.
I think the irony was, what, the green rooms are bad for you? I think
even then it was a revelation because hum pichle 3-4, like agar main apni baat karu, तो मैं 4 साल से मैं सिर्फ सोलो शोज ट्रैवल कर रहा हूँ तो अगर ग्रीन रूम में कुछ हो भी रहा है और किसी लेवल पे हो रहा है तो हम तक तो पहुंच ही नहीं पाते हैं
I've been doing green rooms lately because I'm working on my stand-up special and people listen a lot more. I found that people are listening. Everyone's listening to each other a lot more when I do have like any. It's not eradicated. The boys' club is not. It's still there, but people are trying to change it.
Yeah.
At least the people I work with. Are trying to change that, and I can feel that change around
stuff
me.
Like there's equal lineups now. Like if there is 3 men, there's usually 3 women artists as well, which is something that was never even thought about before.
But also it's like the broker was not even like it wasn't even the representation. It was like a guy would say a joke in the green room and all the boys would be like and I would never feel part of that joke. And that's changed for me. Like now, like people are like making eye contact with me and making and I'm like like not necessarily like that,
but
like but it feels like people are making eye contact and like if at least in the green rooms I've been, it's when too many boys to come around one thing, they will be a bit more conscious about.
Right. So it is becoming more inclusive.
Yes.
And I think this is my experience.
Yeah.
This is what I've noticed for
myself.
Which
is wonderful.
Maybe I'm also asserting myself more, which also helps.
Right.
So, yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Absolutely.
It can be either.
Absolutely. A mix of both.
Has it sensitized you to the kind of jokes you're writing? Like, Zakir, I know, you talk a lot about relationships and men and women, and there has been some criticism of your portrayal of women, like the sucked londa and the woman is always a diva. Has it made you think more?
Agar main apni kahani bata raha hu, aur main waise hi bata raha hu jaisa hua hai.
Correct.
Haan, aur usme jokes.
It's your experience.
It's my experience. So I really don't get what is the question about if it's my experience. Usi tarah ka narrative dusri taraf se bhi aata hai. और वो बहुत एक्सेप्टेबल है तो मेरा ये मेरी अपनी कहानी है मेरी अपनी दास्तान है और ये दुनिया का सबसे बड़ा प्रेमिस है मैन वर्सेस वुमेन लाइक दिस इज हाउ मैन एक्ट एंड दिस इज हाउ वुमेन एक्ट दुनिया का सबसे बड़ा प्रेमिस है ये इसमें हजारों साल से जोक्स हो रहे हैं अभी भी हो रहे हैं और आगे भी होंगे आप उसको रोक नहीं सकते रहा सवाल एज एन आर्टिस्ट आई थिंक लाइक माय लास्ट स्पेशल वाज नॉट अबाउट दैट एक सख्त लौंडा जब मैं अपनी बात कर रहा हूँ तो मैं अपने आप को थोड़ी मैं सख्त बंदी बोल दूँ and it's not about ki ill treat miss or mistreat girls. It's just about that how a person who has a lot of inferiority complexes can avoid rejection or can avoid being played on.
Yeah.
So it's about that. It's not about mistreating any kind of gender or any person. Aur raha sawal meri samajhdari ki, I think all my friends agree with this, that we all are learning, we all are evolving every day. Aur hum sab apna behtar se behtar, hamari audience saath hamara jaisa rishta hai. उनको जितना बेहतर हम समझ के समझा सकते हैं वो हम करने की कोशिश करते हैं
इज योर लेंस ऑन योर ओन राइटिंग मूव्ड एट ऑल या
आई थिंक आई टेक अ ग्रेट इंस्पिरेशन फ्रॉम मूवीज आई थिंक व्हाटएवर इज हैपनिंग इन द फिल्म वर्ल्ड इज व्हाट वी एम like for example, for a movement also, I'm sure equal amount of things has been changed in film industry also, and we are also learning to, because it's the biggest entertainment industry there.
Yeah.
So how we see that the evolution is happening in the movie industry, same in our comedy industry, very small as compared to movie industry. And we all look up to film industry. Mm-hmm. So we are also like learning how others are coping up with issues and how others are helping.
Yeah.
I think the audience is a great decider of what we do. Like, the reason I don't make jokes on religion, it's not that I don't want to. It's because the audience doesn't want it, or they don't react positively to it.
It makes people too uncomfortable.
Yeah. So I think it's very dependent on context and people. The people who get what Me Too was, the people who understand what feminism is, people who understand what how bigotry is wrong, they know what jokes are. Like, they understand a joke. I think when people come to overread into a performance, that's when an issue happens.
And when the people come within a personal agenda, when they are actually looking to diss something,
The smartest people never get offended.
Yeah, the most intelligent, the most well-read people will never get offended.
Because they know that why would we go out of our way to, you know, push a negative agenda? I think most of our jokes, the first purpose is to entertain. It's never to put another person down. It's actually written for the audience. So I think if you get a pushback from the audience, we're like, okay, I won't do that joke. It's not because I would like to say it's because it's wrong or right or what example am I giving. It's like, no, if the audience is pushing back, there's obviously something wrong.
Yeah.
And it's a comedy set. Like, what are you looking for in it? It's meant for people to laugh.
They have come full circle. Now there are jokes about being overly sensitive and aware.
So that's happened. Now that's a
trend. Now we are on the other side of the show.
People are making jokes about liberals. Right.
Yeah.
We've all got now jokes about liberals.
And I don't know how we skipped that part. Whereas like it's like we in India, like, a religion is equal amount of like how you can't talk about. There's another spectrum also, like liberal issues, where you look like how you can't say that.
Correct.
Like, as if there is no bullshit on that side.
Correct.
Everyone's a conservative with liberal and conservative ideologies, but everyone's right now a conservative. No one's budging. Everyone's like, this is what we believe and this is right. And so I'm like, well, you're all the same, by the way. You guys should be friends. Everyone's the same.
Both the wings are equally rigid. Their beliefs are so strong that they're
different ideologies, but
there's no bending.
There's no bending. So, like, as artists, we just see we can see the bullshit and we can call out one, but we are not allowed to call out others.
Correct. You know, I remember in that round table, I think, Zakir, you said that when the AIB roast happened...
I think I shouldn't have been on that. What is it? Is it a recap of that interview?
No. It was very interesting because you said that when the AIB roast happened, everybody's rates went up. Because it was, despite all the controversy around it, it was such a massive success, just in terms of eyeballs and noise, etc., etc. Which leads me to wonder now that AIB is technically not posting anything, at least on the channel. You know, what has been the ripple effect of that? Like, what in terms of just industry, because they were such pioneers in what they did and they opened up so many doors. What has happened? What has happened since then?
What happened since then was straight after that, we started shooting Comicstaan.
I released my special called Kaksha Gyarvi, and it worked really, really well. And then I started writing my season 2 of Chacha Vidayake Hamare, and now I'm working on my third special.
I'm just saying, like, of course, like, it affected, but like, we continue doing what we do.
Right.
You know, we were shooting Comicstaan, that was like a 3-month process.
No, of course. What I meant is a larger industry level, not specifically. Of course, you all went on with whatever projects you were doing.
Yeah.
But just because it's still such a fledgling industry, it is still growing. It's you know, it's being formed. Was there any sort of long term impact of that, or do you foresee any?
I mean, I think the hardest hit was them.
Right. Of course.
They were the hardest hit, and I think I mean, it's always good when there are more players in a field, if there are more voices in a particular profession. So I think the loss of those voices means loss of that perspective. They had a very unique perspective, which is
very original voice.
Yeah. Very original. Like they managed to tie in like new age comedy with Hindi in a way that it was.
So I guess
that's fresh.
But again, there's someone else gonna come and replace that or give a new perspective. But I don't know. I think it made me realize how fragile everything is. That my industry is based on things that can take it down in a day. So I think that humbled me more, and I realized that in our country
that doesn't happen in other industries.
Yeah.
You know, like,
it's bizarre I'm getting to do stand up in this country, because there's no other entertainment field that gives you so much freedom with honesty.
Right.
So I'm like, I'm holding on to it. I'm like, hopefully this will last. Yeah.
And you are mentoring the next 10.
Yeah, okay. Yes. What happened? I know, I'm very moving when I talk. I'm very moving. It's okay.
Oh my God, I'm so sorry.
It's fine.
It's okay. We can cut. I'm glad everything did happen. It really changed things for me personally as a woman.
Right.
A lot. But, you know, no other industry was affected, and everyone was called out, and their industries are like absolutely fine. They're untouched. And ours was affected. And that's what I want to say. It's just, it seems unfair on some level. Like that, I'm not saying that what happened shouldn't have happened. I'm saying then everyone should be accountable for everything that was said.
Right.
People aren't, a lot of people are just continuing their lives without being accountable for what they did.
Yeah.
So even on a broader level, like why it was just like one big wave and then everyone just went back to normal, you know? That's what it feels like.
Yeah.
Sorry.
But to end on happier things,
everyone gets cotton candy.
tell me what surprised you about the kids that you're mentoring? What did you see that you did not expect at all?
I saw one contestant who is such a stand-up comedian, and everything's in her brain, and it's all words, and I was really worried about her in my improv and the sketch rounds. I was like, I don't know how she's going to fare. Like, she's going to do well in the stand-up rounds, but she's really going to bomb in the improv round. And she pulled something out of the hat in the improv round, and I was blown away. Like, I know that's one very specific example of, she absolutely killed. I was so impressed with what she managed to do in the improv round.
Even in sketch, she was good.
And sketch.
Yeah.
So I was just like, we just did not expect someone who was so cerebral to, like, you know, put comedy into their body and be a character and do improv.
I think this is something I noticed in the kids in the first season and second season, which I forgot again. Because every time I see someone who's very naturally funny and just like, wow, this couldn't be planned. And like, I'm a very like instinct-based comedian. So I was like, oh yeah, he's like me, she's like me. And then I go meet them and it just blows my mind that they're so meticulous and so well-planned. And so mathematical about it, and they don't let you see it, which is something that people tell me, right? When they come to, all this is improvised, right? Like, no, I planned the whole thing,
right?
And I forget that I do that myself,
yeah.
And I'm like, you can't be this disciplined at this age.
How wonderful!
Yeah, it's incredibly disciplined at this age, which because you know you think millennials are not disciplined,
correct? Right?
But oh man, it's not a generation thing; it's a very person thing, and it always surprises me. I always forget, and I see someone, I'm like, ah, this is natural talent. And then you talk to them, and they have an Excel sheet every minute. Yeah. And you're like, oh, of course, really. Of course.
How wonderful.
Energy.
Yeah, same.
It's a good energy.
She's reading good energy in the room.
Yeah.
Listen, thank you so much, and all thank best you. For season 2.
Thank you, Anupama.
Thank you.
So much.
Thank you.